Hey guys, before this video starts, I'd just like to say that my new website has been updated. We got some new products. I started off with the liberal tears mug, and that did really well. So I added a feminist tears mug because I saw some people suggesting that, so I put one in. Also, a no safe space here American flag. Sorry about that. And Trump is my president, and that is from the Trump is not my president hashtag that trended on Twitter the day Trump got elected. So that's also available in a number of colors. And also, if you would like to buy any of these products, they ship out very quickly, and everybody that buys a product, I think, will be entered into a giveaway. I think I'm going to give away like an Xbox or a PS4 or something. I haven't decided how I'm going to do that yet, but if you order something, you'll be automatically in the list, and I'll randomly select someone, and voila, you'll probably have a new Xbox. You might. I don't know, so we'll see. So if you guys are interested, it'll be the first link in the description, or it'll be a card on the screen, and go ahead and check it out if you're interested. Thank you. Let's get on with the video.
Excuse me, sir. Can I see your sign?
Sure.
Trump hates women. So, explain that to me.
It's very easy here. I mean, there's a 20-year history of verifiable quotes he's put in books. He says terrible things about women. Here, take that.
Okay, but you think he hates women?
I do. You don't say the things that he does when a respected national news personality that a lot of Republicans appreciate calls him on his misogyny, and he says it's because of her period. It's really sad.
Well, I mean, I'll say he's not very politically correct, but
it's not politically correct.
I mean, I'm sorry his speech offended you.
Oh, he's not offended me.
Well, you're out here protesting, saying he hates women, so he obviously offended you.
My daughter, he's offended me. My fiance, he's offended.
He's offended you too.
How did Donald Trump offend you?
Because he called women fat pigs.
So are you offended by all media that says things about women? He said that to you? Donald Trump said you were a pig?
I'm going to tell you really right now because we're awesome.
Huh? Well, look, I just think that these are lies and false narratives against Donald Trump as a candidate, and it's meant to keep him out of the office, and it's not fair.
They're actually not lies at all. They're
fine. How can you really think that Donald Trump...
You know what he said?
No.
He likes the line in...
Okay, so Hillary Clinton has said many things that are bad about black people and all kinds of people.
What does that have to do with this?
Well, I'm just saying, if you want to sit out here and protest people for their speech, but why don't you protest against Hillary? Why do you only protest Trump? It's because how he's conditioned. It's because it's how you're conditioned. This is how people are conditioned by the media to hate Donald Trump. Let me ask you a question, ladies. Did you have a problem with Donald Trump before he was running for office?
Yeah, I never liked him, actually.
Really?
Yeah, really.
How did you display that? What did you do to protest Donald Trump?
I didn't have to protest him. He wasn't running for president of the United States.
Oh, and that's how the media and the establishment have treated it, too. Where did my sign guy go?
All of our military families.
Okay, the military supports Donald Trump, but that's fine. Hey, where did my sign guy go? He ran away. Oh, wait, I'm going to go get him. We're not letting this guy get away. I at least want to make him look how dumb he really is. Hey. Why'd you walk away from me, man? You didn't want to talk to me, did you? You were afraid I'd school you.
No, you're just kind of random.
Well, I mean, you're out here holding up a sign, so I'm just engaging.
I know, but it's fine.
I'm just engaging in political discourse. So you really think Donald Trump hates women when he's had women campaigning with him? He has women that opens up his rallies. He has put women in very powerful positions at his companies. He's married multiple women. His daughters look up to him. You think he hates women? You think he hates women? He's walking away. This is awesome. He's walking away. This man, hey, look, Donald Trump maybe hates women, maybe he doesn't, but you, sir, are not very intellectual, okay? You're out here protesting Donald Trump, you're out here buying into the conditioning that the mainstream media and the establishment wants you to do, so you're out here protesting Trump, and when I challenge you on your stances, you walk away. You walk away. So you really think Donald Trump hates women, even though many women have come out and praised him, and he puts women in positions of power? Do you really think he hates women?
He has a long history of documenting.
You just keep saying the same thing over and over. Here, he made a nice little list here. How long did it take you to find that list?
These are boring statements. We're talking about hating women would be like women aren't smart enough to
work. Are you okay with him blaming Megyn Kelly's question on her period?
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Listen to this little coward.
Let him talk if I may say.
all around and the rest of women that Bill Clinton raped.
Exactly.
And they had to settle out of court.
Bill Clinton is a rapist. He's
Bill
not just
paid $800,000 to
we're but this man's protesting Trump because that's the programming.
How about when Hillary called Monica Lewinsky a bimbo?
Keep going.
No.
Why don't you protest Hillary and Bill?
He's a rapist. And I mean, since he was at Oxford when he was a Rhodes Scholar, he raped all those women and she harasses them and destroys them. I mean, you must believe the woman.
It's a fact.
I just want to know why
you're protesting Donald Trump but not Hillary or Bill Clinton.
All those women have come forth. Do you believe Bill Clinton?
Because he's programmed, but he can't admit it.
So those women are lying, including Beverly Johnson, the model, and all those people?
Why can't he walk around with his sign?
No one's stopping him from walking around with a sign. If you walk around with a sign like this at the Republican National Convention, you're bound to engage in discourse. I mean, right? I mean, is this absurd or am I...
About surrounding him and
you're right.
What are you talking about? He's out here protesting. This is what he wants.
There's no threat.
Thank you. Yeah, I mean,
see, these people just hate media.
No. You guys aren't surrounding him to have an argument. You guys are creating a dance circle for your boy.
Yeah.
This guy, he's been doing this all day. I don't know. He's kind of funny. Hey, do you have any political beliefs, sir?
No, sir. I just got love in my heart.
Yeah.
Are you going to vote?
Yes, sir.
Who are you going to vote for?
For Hillary.
So, do you like,
He likes rape.
Hold on. Why is the first thing rape? And why do I hate women?
Yeah, it's assassination of Bill Cosby style rapist.
No, you can't liken the two because they both have Bill as their first name. What are you talking about?
Bill Clinton hangs out, with known pedophiles. All right, this guy is just a joke. Yeah, this is a Hillary Clinton supporter. He has no intellect. He just dances in the streets.
This is Hillary right here.
There it is, folks. This is what's going to save America. America's going down the drain and this guy wants to dance in the streets and vote for Hillary. That's going to solve anything. I also want to point out, I think that the the Trump hates women sign guy left again. For the third time, he avoids confrontation. He walks around with a sign against Donald Trump and then he runs away anytime someone wants to challenge him on that sign. That is an ultimate coward. I'm going to see if I can find this guy. He's gone.
This is more than what I expected.
Ready to make America great again? Ready to make America great again? Hey, do you wanna? Let's come over this way and we'll go this way.
No, it does not.
That's hateful, man. That's hate speech.
They say we're promoting hate out here.
All right, we're going into deep cover here.
Bottle put. So we ask her who she's voting for?
Sure.
Who are you voting for? Can I get a hug? Are you voting for Trump?
Do not talk to me. You know I'm not going to start this with you.
Who are you guys voting for?
Go get the megaphone.
I can't get one. No one give me one.
Do you want one?
The People United.
We have one.
I'll get more of them. That's suicide. I'm fine walking around. Talking to a couple people.
This is loud, man. See, but here's the problem with I have, man. They make their type so small. I can't read it from down here, much less from over there. Like, what is the message?
Facts that we already know. It says America is white and black and Latino and Asian.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
Hey, dude, we're aware, dude. I am white and Asian.
Legal,
like,
legal white pride.
We are white America. Looks like. Show me what America looks like. We are what America looks like.
What?
What
America was great for everybody else besides white men?
Yeah.
When?
It's always been
great. Woo! Oh, you should stop lying. You're on candid camera. Like in
1800. She wants me to put up a specific date when I thought America was great. Just because I picked the 1900s, she says I'm racist.
Picked the 1900s,
but
I still wasn't.
How about 1980? The 80s are pretty good.
In 1980, when drugs were implanted into my community, when the homes were divided, when the man could barely make any enough money to bring home his family, so he had to cross the street. That's what you're talking to.
It wasn't bad. I mean, how about the 2010s? How about 2010s?
And you exhibit white privilege flawlessly.
People on the alt-right tell me I'm non-white all the time.
But listen, your white privilege is exhibitedly.
What's my white privilege? My whole family died in concentration camps.
Listen, white privilege is not
that a white privilege?
That doesn't mean your life is easy. It means that systematically.
My parents are from Czechoslovakia.
Wait, can I explain something to you though?
No, I'm from Czechoslovakia.
White privilege. I've been to Czech. White privilege does not mean that you have an easy life. White privilege means that this system is set up for you to succeed and for my people to fail.
Wow.
That's what white privilege is.
Was set up on.
Because the Constitution, go back to the Constitution written by all white men.
All men are created equal.
They didn't. But guess what? I wasn't included as a male in the Constitution.
Yeah, but it's been revised.
I wasn't a whole person in the Constitution.
That's antebellum America. We're talking about after antebellum America.
The Constitution was set up for you.
No, even after antebellum, whatever.
I'm still
to this day.
Yeah,
to
I know.
This day, America has never
we've made
been
so
great
many
for
improvements.
Everybody simultaneously
we've made
at
so many
one time.
Yes, we have.
We've made so many improvements.
People
if
haven't always succeeded.
Were killing there there hasn't. Or they were enslaving black people.
There hasn't always been.
For anybody well, at one time. The only person that it's been great for are you guys.
Well, I mean, we have a black president. Yeah, we have. Whoa. That was a atom bomb.
See if you can get the number one job in the world.
Well, that would be like tyranny if we had the same president.
Honestly, if you don't understand systematic oppression and what white privilege is, you need to go back to history 105 and understand it.
History of social justice, yeah.
Let's say
social justice isn't there.
Yes, I could look at YouTube videos.
Honestly, truly, yeah. I can't argue with people who are willfully ignorant.
No, I'm asking, what do you propose we do about it?
Listen, what I'm saying is make America great again.
Hold on.
You're asking me what we should do about it. If building a wall is your idea of what we should do about it, you
Let's
are being
out
ignorant.
Illegal immigration.
You are an illegal.
But that's not an argument. That's not an argument. You're not making an argument.
You are an illegal immigrant.
No, we were born here.
This land from Native Americans.
We conquered it.
We were born
you
here.
Conquered it, and guess what? When you try to conquer my people's land, your heads got cut off. And now look at my people in Haiti. You guys starved my people.
The Clinton Foundation stole millions from Haiti.
You're making this a race thing.
Good.
Why am I making this a race?
You're a hell of a lot better than you. Over here trying to build a wall to keep out illegal immigrants.
Yeah.
You are the first illegal immigrant.
Look, I was born here. You're talking about me. Is it because I'm white? Is it because I'm white?
I thought you were Filipino.
I'm part white, I'm part Filipino. Is it because I'm white? You want to see my DNA test? I'm part white.
You haven't learned anything from your Filipino side. That's really a shame.
Well, that's not you're not making an argument. I mean, that's still not an argument.
So what's your argument? What's your proposal to make this better for people of color?
My proposal, did you know that actually the people who are most displaced out of work by illegal immigrants is African Americans? It's African Americans illegal immigrants.
Listen,
so if we were to well, it's true. If we were to restrict illegal immigration.
I know about my history. I know about my background. I know what's going on in America that's going against me. And you don't see that you have a privilege. And that's a problem.
Well, I'm talking about the statistics
no,
of it.
You don't see that you have a privilege.
That's not an argument. That's not an argument.
Men like you do not see that you have a privilege.
That's
and a right.
Not,
and that society is set up for you.
That's not an argument.
Exactly, that's what the problem is.
No, this is not. None of this is an argument.
Yeah.
It's easier for minorities to get jobs.
No, you're in a public space.
Do you understand what white privilege is?
What is your definition of it?
I asked you.
I don't believe that white privilege really is a thing that affects society.
You don't believe in statistics?
Well, that's not what I said.
You don't believe in statistics?
What statistics back up the idea of white privilege?
Of systematic oppression?
What are your statistics? You're talking about statistics. What do you want to talk about?
We talked about this last night. I wrote in to tell you.
What statistics?
Statistics show that black people are more likely to be stopped and frisked on the street. Black people are more likely to be killed. Black people are more likely to be convicted. People are more likely to be put in jail for the rest of their life.
And you know, where we could agree is that we should reform drug laws.
I'm not. Don't get into that. What I'm saying.
But I'm trying to find common ground with you. I mean, we could solve a lot of the incarceration. I'm saying we can.
You understand the problems, and you think it's funny, and that's the problem.
No, I want to reform the drug laws.
You
guys aren't listening to me. You guys aren't listening to us.
Where my mind is, we would never find common ground. We would never be equal.
We wouldn't. You don't want to decriminalize marijuana?
Guess what? the knowledge I have, you will never have. You are willfully ignorant.
Why do you associate drugs with black people?
Because a majority of people who are convicted on possession charges are African American. A disproportionate amount.
Those are the ones that get kicked on the most. Those are the ones that get stuck.
I said convicted. I said convicted, yeah.
But I know you probably smoke weed. Honestly, he probably smoked weed. But
I don't,
but... You will never get convicted because you will never get stopped on traffic.
So, can we agree that it would be good to decriminalize marijuana? So,
no, it would be good if police stop you too.
So it should be illegal for everyone?
No, we should stop.
No, I'm trying to find an agreement place to agree with you.
Listen, we will never agree with each other. My knowledge is way above yours. I'm sorry.
Really, is that so? Okay. Well, then we're not.
I don't know what a systematic oppression is.
So your knowledge is way above mine. Okay. Okay. What was your SAT score?
That doesn't even matter.
You know, if you want to talk about knowledge, what was your SAT score? You know?
No, you couldn't.
What job are you going for?
What's your major? I'm finance with a minor in Spanish. What's up, boo?
Political science.
What's up? I don't give a fuck. I'll take that job, too. What's up?
You're going to be a lawyer?
He smells like Bahamas right now. You smell like beer.
He probably been like
beer. You're just not making arguments. You're insulting us.
I am. Because you're ignorant. You're smiling. Can I
just ask you a truthful?
Yeah, because you guys are not making a single argument.
I want to calm this down. I want to ask a question. When was America great for everyone, for every race? When you say make America great,
after the 70s. After the 70s.
You said 1960s earlier.
But listen.
Because you guys always, there's always racism involved.
It's a concept. It's a social construct.
He's talking about his
But I want to hear a solid time when America was great for every race besides white men. I want to hear a time when white men were oppressed.
The Irish. Easy. The Irish. Well, you're making fun of me, but that's when.
Listen,
but that is European.
My whole family died in concentration camps.
No, but she wanted me to name a time when white people were oppressed, and I came to time. When the Irish came over, they were mistreated.
That's what they're being oppressed by. You!
I'm part Irish. My predominant white heritage is Irish. So
wait,
you want to see my DNA test?
Hey, you are whatever, but when people see you on the street, they see white. When cops pull you up,
so the facts don't matter. The facts don't matter then. So the facts don't matter.
Terrorists in America.
ISIS.
White Christian males. 80% of terrorism.
She's gonna pull it up on Wikipedia.
White men are the biggest terrorists known to America.
Right.
You guys have created slavery.
Yes.
Mass genocide.
You know who created slavery? The Arabs. The Arabs started the slave trade.
It's called that race.
The Arab slave trade was going on for hundreds of years before the white slave trade.
When Trump first started, when Trump
actually
was as cruel in slavery.
Factually untrue.
I'm a CES major. I study these histories.
That's not helping your argument. I mean,
they had indentured servitude.
Nobody was as cruel in slavery.
We were the only white Americans. I understand, but that's not us. I didn't enslave anybody. Can I explain something to you?
That was back in the
I don't want it to. I don't want to have slaves.
That never happened to you.
This is our history in America, okay?
Right here.
This much.
This is race history.
This much. We have been enslaved.
What, us getting yelled at is our history in America?
We have been free. So if I come off aggressive, I'm passionate. My great-grandmother can tell me about getting beat. Do you understand that? So don't tell me it was a long time ago. It was not a long time ago. I have been free for this.
My grandpa can tell me about his concentration camp experience.
But guess what? Oh, guess what? I'm from Germany. Guess the difference between Germany and America. Germany's ashamed. America's not.
Yeah. It should be allowed. Well, I mean, not. Legal immigrants in general that are already here shouldn't be taken away. Because obviously for jobs, and you're tearing families apart, and it's not even worth it. Our companies if you just, you know, get rid of them.
Bernie Sanders is a lifelong progressive, been following him for generations.
I don't want to cut you off, but I never saw him. I never met him. I was chair of the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee for 3 years, from 1963 to 1966. I was involved in the sit-ins, the Freedom Ride, the March on Washington, the March from Selma to Montgomery, and directed the Voter Education Project for 6 years. but I met Hillary Clinton. I met President.
Bernie is a genuine human. I feel like he's very genuine, and that's the reason he relates to so many people. Because he's speaking from his heart.
Excuse me, shut up! You don't have the microphone.
But he's also explaining why he wants to look out for the person, the people in this country who need help.
One of Bernie's policies is that he wants to heavily tax the rich. Do you think that would encourage them to leave?
To leave?
Yes.
The rich are not going to leave America. That's a...
No way.
You know, they're so rich they can afford to have Bernie tax them, and that wouldn't be a problem.
So,
where are they going to go? Are they going to go somewhere where they're not taxed?
Yeah. Yes.
Let's say you were renting an apartment in New York, and the landlord said to you that he's going to raise your rent by 50% to cover the people who cannot afford the rent. Would you stay in the apartment?
That is not a parallel analogy. There's no way that's a parallel analogy. You know, this is the one place where they get the tax break. So where are they going to go?
Okay.
I believe he will rebuild the middle class, which America was born on, and it is deteriorating.
How is he going to rebuild the middle class?
By fixing infrastructure, by creating jobs, and bringing jobs away from foreign countries and back to the United States.
Raise the minimum wage to $5.50 an hour.
We've got to raise the minimum wage to at least $10.10 an hour.
Raise the minimum wage to a living wage, $15 an hour.
First of all, it would kill jobs. One of the basic lessons of economics is that when the price of something goes up, people buy less of it. So if the price of pumpkin lattes rises, you can expect consumers to buy fewer of them. This law of demand also affects the market for low-skilled workers. Raising the minimum wage means a higher cost of employing each worker, which makes workers less affordable than before. Our coffee shop won't keep a worker at the
minimum. I believe that he stands for the change that we need to see in the world. And I think he's cool.
Do you think it's wrong for a presidential candidate to marginalize a group of people based on the color of their skin?
Yeah, absolutely. I think not just the presidential candidate, just the regular human being.
When you're white, you don't know what it's like to be living in a ghetto. You don't know what it's like to be poor. When you're white, we will end institutional racism.
Let's say you're renting an apartment and the landlord tells you that he's raising your rent by 50% to help pay for the people who cannot afford to pay rent. Would you pay the rent?
Absolutely would, under certain circumstances. For example, I would, if I had,
come on, try getting it out.
Income great enough where I was paying, you know, living comfortably, paying my rent and saving. Yeah, I would totally, you know, as a charitable cause, yeah, I would help out, yeah.
Why do you think most people of color are voting for Hillary?
Well, I personally don't think most people of color are voting for Hillary.
You saw that stat from the NBC Marist poll that Clinton is leading Sanders among support from African Americans in South Carolina by, look at that, 74% right. To 17%.
Oh, would you look at that?
Put that
just
on.
Look at that.
The fact is that it was the African-American vote in Nevada that really put Hillary Clinton over the top tonight. They broke more than 3-1 for her.
Would you just look at it?
Yeah, it's sad. It's the only mark.
I mean, just look at it.
She has the most support among women and African-American voters.
Collecting far more endorsements, including from Eric Garner's mother.
Hillary tends to have a higher support within minorities in those states. So it's basically coincidental that that's happening.
Right.
You know, I'll go down.
You'll still do it.
Park. Do you think we should build a wall?
My personal opinion is you, no matter how big of a wall you're going to build, there's always going to be a way to, you know, penetrate. And especially if there's a big enough need that, you know, I think the wall is not the final solution. I think what's really going to build a realistically sustainable solution is what Bernie's campaign is trying to accomplish.
Bernie Sanders got me out here. I don't vote because I don't believe in the political system at all. I haven't taken part in anything political in this country since John V. Lindsay.
In case Hillary wins the nomination, hypothetically, you would vote for Donald Trump?
Well, first of all, I don't vote.
I grow my own food.
Okay. Hey, check yourself, dude.
Patriarchy runs the world, so check your white male privilege.
Okay. Check yourself. What? Are you gonna go on white privilege? Are you a social justice warrior? Are you some kind of white knight now? You're gonna come to save
everybody? I'm not claiming to be a white knight.
All right. Well, I'm talking to her.
How do we do it?
I'm a Trump supporter, but we can still get along.
Make America love again, right?
Make America love again!
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 America love again!
Young, you tell us to love everybody. Yep. What you're doing is you are harassing the people that are standing in this line to go to this event.
That's right.
Okay, we're not. We're, you know, if you want to love everybody, you wouldn't start these kind of things. You wouldn't carry a sign that's just going
to
make people mad.
We're supporting the people that we love. We're here, like, trying to stand up for what we believe.
Democrats? What is going on with the Democrats?
This is not political. This is not political.
This is not political.
This is not with a political party. I'm here because I'm supporting the students of color at Lawrence and the people of color in America and in Appleton and all around that are not, that feel threatened, that don't feel safe because of this exact kind of gathering.
I would say that everything is right, but I think he's got some legitimate.
He's trying to build a wall to block out Mexicans. Why is that?
No. He's not trying to build a wall to block out Mexicans. He's trying to build a wall to block out, to secure the border.
Trump's a phony!
Yes, he is!
Woo! Trump's a phony!
Yes, he is!
But first, let me take a selfie.
Yes!
Trump's a phony!
Yes, he is!
Trump's a phony!
Did you hear Saudi Arabia today? They want to have the death penalty for gay people. What do you think of that?
I do not support that. I think if you're going to have the death penalty, you can't just limit the death penalty to a certain group of people. If you're going to have the death penalty, fine. It has to be for everyone. It can't just be for a certain group of people.
Wrong!
What news network are you from? I'm just curious.
It says InfoWars right here.
Don't Trump! Don't Trump! Don't Trump!
The quickest way to clear out a protest.
Have a good one.
Thank you.
What do we want?
Equality!
But first, let me take a selfie.
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Equality!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Equality!
When?
Now!
What?
Equality!
But first, let me take a selfie.
Now you're just looking for coverage, right?
That's first.
Hey, if you...
I mean, you get...
Do not interrupt me! Do not interrupt me!
Do not interrupt me!
So you're a Miss Andrews, got it. All right. Miss Andrews doesn't exist. You hate men. Let's think a man talking down to me, please.
I
say the same thing I do to him as I do to you.
Hey guys.
I gotta go.
Check your white male privilege.
Love not hate.
All right, we're out out here at Washington State University celebrating President Trump's miraculous victory. We're here trying to have conversations with people. Obviously, FDT is playing in the background for like the fifth time today. And the civil discourse here. And the civil discourse here is just amazing. We actually have some decent conversations, but also a lot of just that as well too. So let's see what happens when we have the rest of these conversations here at Washington State University. President Trump?
No.
You guys excited for the President 45?
Bye.
Why is he our president? He's got to be president. People are not excited for President Trump, you guys.
You guys excited for President Trump?
Absolutely not. I don't like fascism.
Why is Trump a fascist?
Trump, please do not record me.
Okay, we'll go talk to other people.
All right.
Hail Trump.
But you know, I'm not on either side, but yeah. I just prefer this just because I'm from Syria. And, you know, I don't want Hillary Clinton to go into Syria.
Dude, I mean, prefer, she says she wants to bomb it.
And she's corrupt, so yeah, exactly. I don't think I'm that involved in politics, but I respect everyone's decision.
You guys excited for President Trump?
I'm sorry, but can you please step aside? We're not near you.
President
We're
Trump, on this right?
Side. Can you please step aside?
President
Trump. Not a lot of excitement here, dude. Kind of upset, but hey, it's okay.
Why are you trying to cuss? Not our president.
We're just mingling.
Somebody
got assaulted.
Oh my god, a slap in the phone.
Yeah, I mean, that is
assault. You know, Muslim assaults have gone up 89% since Trump even went for running for prison. Is it in your fucking mind all these people you're impacting right now? I talked to you last time. You're treating me like shit. Quit looking me in the eye. You made fun of everyone drunk out to the last person. Can you back
she
away?
Obviously doesn't want to be
it's public space. It's public space.
It's our freedom of speech.
We just got deported. Illusion. Wow, dude. People were pissed. That girl was literally about to cry because we had a clipboard. He is your president, though. No, that girl was like about to cry because I was talking to her.
I remember when Obama won and people said he's not our president and people lost their
shit. Yeah, yeah. Throwback to 2012 and 2008, people were like, oh, Romney is my president and Obama's not my president. Well, Romney is your president, is not your president. Obama is your president because he won.
Oh boy,
it's our greatest strength.
I feel culturally enriched.
I've learned a lot today.
We have such a civil discourse. Man, this is so peaceful and nice.
This is helping my ignorance.
I'm really feeling educated.
Hey guys, I'm a white American. Yeah! My man! Yeah! Woo!
Man, I really wish I could.
I love being a white man.
How do you prove that?
How do you prove it?
Yeah. Are we innocent until proven guilty in this country?
No, I'm not. They're not.
That's not a crime. We're talking about corruption.
Okay, what about the several?
See,
She just said, aside from all of that, to ignore those things. They're focusing on the corruption issue.
The plaintiffs in all of the rape cases, alleged rape cases, dropped them all. The 13-year-old rape victim dropped it a week before the audit because it was fake. Charges, so it's all conjecture.
Because he has the money to get out of it. The child disappeared.
Can you prove this?
She disappeared.
Yeah.
She
dropped the case.
No, she didn't drop the case. She disappeared.
Okay. Not back to
you.
Juan Alvarez, and I'm the director of the Latin American Organization for Immigrant Rights. Okay. So when you say illegal people coming to this country, I think the U.S. is paying a price for that.
Over $100 billion a year.
For the foreign policy of the United States in Latin American countries, mainly my country, Guatemala City, Central America. Okay, wars created by the Republican Party in those countries, my country, 39 years of wars, for what? Just to protect the United States from the communists to come over here to the United States, to keep the backyard of the United States safe. So we pay a price for that, and the United States is paying a price now, because with all those wars created in the 80s, forced people to leave their countries.
So what do you think the solution is?
The solution is, I've been saying this all the way along, you know, they should work, instead of ripping off our countries, they should work with the governments over there, create jobs, and people is going to stop coming over here.
But you have to recognize that Trump, more than any other candidate, has been reaching out to these countries to try to actually build relationships.
No, because what he wants is to keep the 1% up, to keep the white race on top of us.
What makes you say that?
Because you can see this all over the United States.
I haven't seen it.
I've seen it.
So give me an example.
You are proof of that.
How am I proof? What am I proof of?
You fighting to stay on top of the minorities.
No.
Yes, sir, you are. You
know, no, no.
Did you see the internet with the Trump supporters saying that they're going to kill all the niggers?
No.
If Trump wins?
That's never happened.
What makes you think they won? See,
what about people who say they want to kill Trump and Trump supporters? It happens on both sides.
They have because what he's been creating is division, okay? And we are afraid of Trump, and white people is afraid of us. And it shouldn't be like that.
I'm not afraid of you.
You can see that. Not you, but you see a lot of people say, let's go out and kill all the illegal immigrants. Let's go out and kill all the Hispanics.
I mean, there's crazy people in all societies, but I think that you're talking about a non-serious issue.
He's creating a situation that we are worse than in the 1960s. We're going back.
Now, but hold on, sir. But Donald Trump has never been in government, so why are you blaming Trump for this?
Because everybody loves Trump. The white people love Trump.
So do black people, so do Latinos.
Because they don't know what they're doing, you know? They don't know what they're doing. What makes you think that Trump is going to treat me better than you?
Well, I'm not looking for Trump to treat me like anything. I just want a president who doesn't want to sell America down the drain.
He's a crook, man. He's a crook.
How so?
Bankruptcies, cheating his wives, stuff like that.
Well, I don't know what crook you're talking about with his wives, but most business owners have bankruptcies.
Problems he had in the past. Do you know?
I'm sorry, what's that?
Do you know how many legal problems he has in his past? Until right now, everybody's suing him because he does do this, he do that.
He's got a civil suit for Trump University. What other suits?
He kicked his way up. He see you down, he push you down. That's the way he is, man. He's not good.
What are you
president.
Talking about?
He's not president. He's not good for president. Can you trust a guy that snapped like this with nuclear weapons?
What evidence do you have that he would be like that with nuclear weapons?
You can see it. Kick that baby out. Do this and do that. He hates other people that think otherwise.
I have to be honest with you, sir. I think that you're kind of being tricked by the mainstream media.
I'm a living proof that I'm here and I work hard here, and he wants to kick us out of here.
So are you, let me ask you a question, sir. Okay, I was going to ask you, did you immigrate to America?
Yes.
From where?
From Guatemala, Central America. And I already told you. If you ask many people from Guatemala, they wouldn't want to be here because of the war we flee our countries.
So why, since you came here legally, why wouldn't you want justice and other people to follow the same process as you?
Because it takes too many years, my friend.
Donald Trump says he wants to expedite the process.
How?
He's going to cut things to make it easier to become a citizen of the United States. He's released plans.
how? You got people waiting 20 years in their countries to come over here.
Yeah, and Trump has said he's going to make it easier to be a citizen.
He can say that, but he's not going to be able to do it.
So you just don't trust anything he says?
The system is set up for that.
So how come you trust him when he says things that you think are racist, but then he says things that are good and you don't trust him?
We can wait and see if it's going to happen, and time and history will tell you that he's not telling the truth.
All right, do me a favor. If you could say one thing to Donald Trump, look in the camera and tell what you would say to Donald Trump right now.
What would I say to him? To quit blaming other people, Hispanic people, minorities, for the problem of the United States. The United States is in trouble because of the banks, the big banks, because of the rich people. We are not creating any problem to this country. I'm here to work for this country, and I'm willing to die for this country.
Yeah, so you're a legal American citizen, so he's not talking about you, and he's pointed out that big banks and that big money in government is part of the problem. So Trump actually is probably your candidate.
No. No, because the thing he said about Hispanics, Mexicans.
Illegal immigrants.
They are not illegal.
They broke the law.
Did you check the law?
So are you for an open border policy?
I already told you, I'm not open for that. We cannot take more people in, but they need to work with the countries to keep people to come over here.
Don't you think, though, a man who's been outside the established government would be the one to come in and fix these relationships?
There is nobody with a magic wand to fix the problem in the United States.
I agree. It's up to the American people.
Correct.
Thank you for your time.
Go out and vote to see the difference, because neither of the two candidates that we have right now are good for America.
So who are you going to vote for, sir?
I don't know yet.
You don't know?
I don't know. There is no third party. There is no other options. So you have to take the less evil of the two of them. In this case, Hillary Clinton.
All right, sir. Thank you for your time.
So am I, but the Native Americans are like questioning.
This is why hold up.
Why are you carrying a gun?
Because I'm a fucking American.
Yeah,
I have that right. Don't touch him, man.
I have the right.
You touch him, you're down.
This is my Second Amendment right. This is my Second Amendment right.
Okay, yeah.
Are you an American?
Yeah. I'm American. Why are you born in Mexico?
I'm never going to do that again.
It's all right. Okay.
He asked me, why am I carrying a gun? Because I'm an American citizen.
Stay away from him.
Are you an American citizen? Are you an American citizen? Why are you not carrying a gun?
Because he doesn't want to carry a gun and add to the assholes. He doesn't want to add to the assholes like you.
It's nothing to do with... Oh my God, I'm an asshole.
Yeah, right.
Because I'm defending myself.
You're an American, ma'am. What do you have a Mexican flag for?
Man,
absolutely.
Because he's Mexican. That's right. Nice tattoo below the eyes.
I'm from America.
You just got out of here.
I'm Mexican and American.
Nice tattoo there, buddy. You need a teardrop tattoo.
Why do you think Trump is a racist?
Trump is a... He doesn't like women. He doesn't like blacks. He doesn't like Hispanics. And he doesn't like Muslims.
He's hired more Hispanic workers in this country than
all
the
Hispanics.
White people don't do the damn job, asshole!
No, I'm not. Why do you have to... Why are we calling names?
I'm white.
Why are we calling names?
So, white people don't like Trump just as much as assholes.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Why don't you go get a job?
I have a job.
I'll do you. What?
I will do it.
I'm a food stamp hero.
What? Don't even think of it.
Infowars.com. Outside of the Donald Trump rally here in Phoenix, Arizona.
It's not going to happen. You're not going to happen.
You don't like America, leave.
Hey guys, before this video starts, I'd just like to say that my new website has been updated. We got some new products. I started off with the Liberal Tears mug, and that did really well. So I added a Feminist Tears mug because I saw some people suggesting that, so I put one in. Also, a No Safe Space Here American flag. Sorry about that. And Trump is my president, and that is from the Trump is not my president hashtag that trended on Twitter the day Trump got elected. So that's also available in a number of colors. And also, if you would like to buy any of these products, they ship out very quickly, and everybody that buys a product, I think, will be entered into a giveaway. I think I'm going to give away like an Xbox or a PS4 or something. I haven't decided how I'm going to do that yet, but if you order something, you'll be automatically in the list, and I'll randomly select someone, and voila, you'll probably have a new Xbox. You might. I don't know. So we'll see. So if you guys are interested, it'll be the first link in the description, or it'll be a card on the screen, and go ahead and check it out if you're interested. Thank you. Let's get on with the video.
Excuse me, sir. Can I see your sign? Trump hates women. So, explain that to me.
It's very easy here. I mean, there's a 20-year history of verifiable quotes he's put in books. He says terrible things about women. Here, take that.
Okay, but you think he hates women?
I do. You don't say the things that he does when a respected national news personality that a lot of Republicans appreciate calls him on his misogyny, and he says it's because of her period. It's really sad.
Well, I mean, I'll say he's not very politically correct, but
it's not politically correct.
I mean, I'm sorry his speech offended you.
Oh, he's not offended me.
Well, you're out here protesting, saying he hates women, so he obviously offended you.
He's offended my daughter. Offended he's offended me. My fiance. He's offended.
He's offended you too.
How did Donald Trump offend you?
Because he called women fat pigs.
So are you offended by all media that says things about women? He said that to you? Donald Trump said you were a pig?
I'm going to tell you really right now because we're awesome.
Huh? Well, look, I just think that these are lies and false narratives against Donald Trump as a candidate, and it's meant to keep him out of the office, and it's not fair.
They're actually not lies at all. They're
fine. How can you really think that Donald Trump...
You know what he said?
No.
He likes the line in...
Okay, so Hillary Clinton has said many things that are bad about black people and all kinds of people.
What does that have to do with this?
Well, I'm just saying, if you want to sit out here and protest people for their speech, but why don't you protest against Hillary? Why do you only protest Trump? It's because how he's conditioned. It's because it's how you're conditioned. This is how people are conditioned by the media to hate Donald Trump. Let me ask you a question, ladies. Did you have a problem with Donald Trump before he was running for office?
Yeah, I never liked him, actually.
Really?
Yeah, really.
How did you display that? What did you do to protest Donald Trump?
I didn't have to protest him. He wasn't running for president of the United States.
Oh, and that's how the media and the establishment have treated it, too. Where did my sign guy go?
All of our military families leave.
Okay, the military supports Donald Trump, but that's fine.
Hillary supports right.
Hey, where did my sign guy go? He ran away. Oh, wait, I'm going to go get him. We're not letting this guy get away. I at least want to make him look how dumb he really is. Hey. Why'd you walk away from me, man? You didn't want to talk to me, did you? You were afraid I'd school you.
No, you're just kind of random.
Well, I mean, you're out here holding up a sign, so I'm just engaging.
I know, but it's fine.
I'm just engaging in political discourse. So you really think Donald Trump hates women when he's had women campaigning with him? He has women that opens up his rallies. He has put women in very powerful positions at his companies. He's married multiple women. His daughters look up to him. You think he hates women? You think he hates women? He's walking away. This is awesome. He's walking away. This man, hey, look, Donald Trump maybe hates women, maybe he doesn't, but you, sir, are not very intellectual, okay? You're out here protesting Donald Trump. You're out here buying into the conditioning that the mainstream media and the establishment wants you to do. So you're out here protesting Trump, and when I challenge you on your stances, you walk away. You walk away. So you really think Donald Trump hates women, even though many women have come out and praised him, and he puts women in positions of power? Do you really think he hates women?
He has a long history of documenting.
You just keep saying the same thing over and over. Here, he's got a... He made a nice little list here. How long did it take you to find that list?
These are boring statements. We're talking about hating women would be like women aren't smart enough to work.
Are you okay with him blaming Megyn Kelly's question on her period?
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. Listen to this little coward.
Wait, let him talk, if I may say.
Fall around and harass the women that Bill Clinton raped.
Exactly.
And they had to settle out of court.
Bill Clinton is a rapist. He's not just a woman.
Bill Clinton paid $800,000 to
We're but this man's protesting Trump because that's the programming.
How about when Hillary called Monica Lewinsky a bimbo?
No. Well, why don't you protest Hillary and Bill?
He's a rapist. And, I mean, since he was at Oxford when he was a Rhodes Scholar, he raped all those women, and she harasses them and destroys them. I mean, this is, you must believe the woman.
It's a fact. I just want to know why you're protesting Donald Trump but not Hillary or Bill Clinton.
All those women have come forth. Do you believe Bill Clinton?
Because he's programmed, but he can't admit it.
So those women are lying? Including Beverly Johnson, Jamal, and all those people?
Why can't he walk around with his sign?
No one's stopping him from walking around with a sign. If you walk around with a sign like this at the Republican National Convention, you're bound to engage in discourse. I mean, right? I mean, is this absurd or am I...
It's just about surrounding him and trying
you're right.
to...
What are you talking about? He's out here protesting. This is what he wants.
There's no threat.
Thank you. Yeah, I mean...
See, these people just hate media.
Hold on. You guys aren't surrounding him to have an argument. You guys are creating a dance circle for your boy.
Yeah.
This guy, he's been doing this all day. I don't know. He's kind of funny. Hey, do you have any political beliefs, sir?
No, sir. I just got love in my heart.
Yeah.
Are you going to vote?
Yes, sir.
Who are you going to vote for?
For Hillary.
So, do you like,
He likes rapists. He likes rape.
Hold on.
He hates rape.
Hold on. Why is the first thing rape? And why do I hate women?
Yeah, it's assassination to Bill Cosby-style rapist.
No, you can't liken the two because they both have Bill as their first name. What are you talking about?
Bill Clinton hangs out. Bill Clinton hangs out with known pedophiles. All right, this guy is just a joke. Yeah, this is, hey, guys, this is a Hillary Clinton supporter. He has no intellect. He just dances in the streets.
This is Hillary right here.
There it is, folks. This is what's going to save America. America's going down the drain, and this guy wants to dance in the streets and vote for Hillary. That's going to solve anything. I also want to point out, I think that the, I think that the Trump hates women sign guy left again. For the third time, he avoids confrontation. He walks around with a sign against Donald Trump, and then he runs away anytime someone wants to challenge him on that sign. That is an ultimate coward. I'm going to see if I can find this guy. He's gone.
This is more than what I expected.
Yeah. Ready to make America great again? Ready to make America great again? Hey, do you wanna? Let's come over this way and we'll go this way.
No, it does not.
That's hateful, man. That's hate speech.
They say we're promoting hate out here.
All right, we're going into deep cover here.
Bottle for. Should we ask her who she's voting for?
Sure.
Who are you voting for? Can I get a hug? No. Are you voting for Trump?
Do not talk to me. You know I'm not gonna start this with you.
Who are you guys voting for?
Not Trump.
Go get the megaphone.
I can't get one. No one give me one.
Do you want one?
The People United.
We have one.
I get more of them. That's suicide. I'm fine walking around and talking to a couple people.
This is loud, man. See, but here's the problem with I have, man. They make their type so small. I can't read it from down here, much less from over there. Like, what is the message?
Facts that we already know. It says America is white and black and Latino and Asian.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
Hey, dude, we're aware, dude. I am white and Asian.
Legal,
like,
legal white pride.
We are white America looks like. Show me what America looks like.
We are what America looks like.
It's always been
there. Woo! Somebody should stop lying. You're on candid camera. Like in 1800.
She wants me to put up a specific date when I thought America was great. Just because I picked the 1900s, she says I'm racist.
Picked the 1900s, I still wasn't
even. How about 1980? The 80s were pretty good.
When he brought it over.
In 1980, when drugs were implanted into my community, when the homes were divided, when the man could barely make any enough money to bring home his family so he had his house in the street, that's what you're talking to.
It wasn't bad. I mean, how about the 2010s?
And you exhibit white privilege flawlessly.
I'm people on the alt-right tell me I'm non-white all the time.
But listen, your white privilege is exhibitly...
What's my white privilege? My whole family died in concentration camps.
Listen, white privilege is not...
How is that a white
privilege?
I'm...
That doesn't mean your life is easy. It means that systematically...
I was... My parents are from Czechoslovakia.
Wait, can I explain something though?
No, I'm from Czechoslovakia.
I've been to Czech. White privilege does not mean that you have an easy life. White privilege means that this system is set up for you to succeed and for my people to fail. That's what white privilege is.
Was set up on.
Because the Constitution, go back to the Constitution written by all white
all
males.
All men are created equal.
They didn't include. But guess what? I wasn't included as a male in the Constitution.
Yeah, but it's been revised.
I wasn't a whole person in the Constitution.
That's antebellum America. We're talking about after antebellum America.
The Constitution was set up for you.
No, even after antebellum, whatever.
I'm still
to this day.
Yeah,
to
I know
this
that.
Day, America has never
we've made
been
so
great
many
for
improvements.
Everybody simultaneously
we've made
at
so many
one
improvements.
Time.
Yes, we have.
People haven't always succeeded. There hasn't.
Or they were enslaving black people.
There hasn't always been.
The only person that has been great for are you guys.
Well, I mean, we have a black president. Yeah, Whoa. That was an atom bomb.
See if you can get the number one job in the world.
Well, that would be like tyranny if we had the same president.
Honestly, if you don't understand systematic oppression and what white privilege is,
you know.
No, you couldn't. I'm finance with a minor in Spanish. What's up, boo? What's up? I don't give a fuck. I'll take that job too. What's up?
You gonna be a lawyer?
You smell like Bahamas right now. You smell like beer.
You're just not making arguments. You're insulting us.
I am. Yeah. You're ignorant. You're smiling.
Can I just ask you a truthfully?
Yeah, because you guys are not making a single argument.
I want to calm this down. I want to ask a question. When was America great for everyone, for every race? When you say make America
after
great
the 70s. For everyone, after the 70s.
You said 1960s earlier,
but listen.
Because you guys always, there's always racism involved.
Because listen,
it's an idea. Race is an idea, not an
eugenics. Race is a concept. It's a concept. It's a social construct.
He's talking out his ass.
But I want to hear a solid time. When America was great for every race besides white men. I want to hear a time when white men were oppressed.
The Irish. Well, you're making fun of me, but that's when... But that is your opinion.
My whole family died in concentration camps.
No, but she wanted me to name a time when white people were oppressed, and I came to time. When the Irish came over, they were mistreated.
That's when they were being oppressed by
you.
I'm part Irish. My predominant white heritage is Irish. So you want to see my DNA test? So the facts don't matter. The facts don't matter then. So the facts don't matter.
Terrorists in America.
ISIS.
White Christian males. 80% of terrorism.
She's gonna pull it up on Wikipedia.
White men are the biggest terrorists known to America.
Right.
You guys have created slavery.
Yes.
Mass genocide.
You know who created slavery? The Arabs. The Arabs started the slave trade.
It's called that race.
The Arab slave trade was going on for hundreds of years before the white slave trade.
Talking about. When
no,
Trump
look.
When Trump
actually
was as cruel in slavery.
Factually untrue. That's not helping your argument. I mean,
they had indentured servitude.
Nobody was as cruel in slavery.
We were the only
white Americans.
I understand, but that's not us.
I didn't enslave anybody.
Can I explain something to you?
That was back in the
I don't want it to. I don't want to have slaves.
Never happened to you.
This is our history in America, okay?
Right here.
This much, we have been enslaved.
Us getting yelled at is our history in America?
So if I come off aggressive, I'm passionate. My great-grandmother can tell me about getting beat. Do you understand that? So don't tell me it was a long time ago. It was not a long time ago. I have been free for this.
My grandpa can tell me about his concentration camp experience.
But guess what? Oh, guess what? I'm from Germany. Guess the difference between Germany and America.
Oh,
Germany
so
is a shame. America's not.
Yeah. It should be allowed. Well, I mean, not. Legal immigrants in general that are already here shouldn't be taken away. Because obviously for jobs, and you're tearing families apart, and it's not even worth it. Destroy companies if you just... know, get rid of them.
Bernie Sanders is a lifelong progressive. Been following him for generations.
I don't want to cut you off, but I never saw him. I never met him. I was chair of the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee for 3 years, from 1963 to 1966.
We need to go back to history 105 and understand it.
History actually, of social justice, yeah.
Actually, let's say, there,
you can look at YouTube.
Let's say social justice isn't there.
Yes, I could look at YouTube videos.
Honestly, truly, yeah. I can't argue with people who are willfully ignorant.
No, I'm asking, what do you propose we do about it?
Listen, what I'm saying is, make America great again.
Hold on.
You're asking me what we should do about it. If building a wall is your idea of what we should do about it, you are being ignorant.
Keeping out illegal immigration.
You are an illegal immigrant.
But that's not an argument. You're not making an argument.
You are an illegal immigrant.
No, we were born here.
You stole this land from Native Americans.
We conquered it.
We were born
you
here.
You conquered it, and guess what? When you try to conquer my people's land, your heads got cut off. And now look at my people in Haiti. You guys starved my people.
The Clinton Foundation stole millions from Haiti.
You're making this a race thing.
Good.
You are a lot better than you. We're trying to build a wall to keep out illegal immigrants. You are the first illegal immigrant.
I was born here. You're talking about me. Is it because I'm white? Is it because I'm white? I'm part white. I'm part Filipino. Is it because I'm white? You want to see my DNA test? I'm part white. Well, that's not you're not making an argument. I mean, that's still not an argument.
So what's your argument? What's your proposal to make this better for people of color?
My proposal, did you know that actually the people who are most displaced out of work by illegal immigrants is African Americans? It's African Americans illegal immigrants.
Listen,
so if we were to well, it's true. If we were to restrict illegal immigration.
I'm talking about the statistics of it. That's not an argument.
That's not an argument.
That's what the problem is.
No, this is not. None of this is an argument.
It's easier for minorities to get jobs.
No, you're in a public space.
Do you understand what white privilege is?
What is your definition of it?
I asked you.
I don't believe that white privilege really is a thing that impacts society.
You don't believe in statistics?
Well, that's not what I said.
You don't believe in statistics?
What statistics back up the idea of white privilege?
Of systematic oppression?
What are your statistics? You're talking about statistics. What do you want to talk about?
We talked about this last night. I wrote in to tell you.
What statistics?
Statistics show that black people are more likely to be stopped and frisked on the street. Black people are more likely to be killed. Black people are more likely to be convicted. Black people are more likely to be put in jail for the rest of their life.
And you know, where we could agree is that we should reform drug laws.
Don't get into that. What I'm saying is,
but I'm trying to find common ground with you. I mean, we could solve a lot of the incarceration.
I want to reform the drug laws.
You guys aren't listening to me. You guys aren't listening to us.
Where my mind is, we would never find common ground. We would never be equal.
You don't want to decriminalize marijuana?
Guess what? The knowledge I have, you will never have. You are willfully ignorant.
Why do you associate drugs with black people?
Because a majority of people who are convicted on possession charges are African American. A disproportionate amount.
Those are the ones that get kicked on the most. Those are the ones that get stuck.
I said convicted, yeah.
But I know you probably smoke weed. Honestly, he probably smoked weed.
I don't, but...
You will never get convicted because you will never get stopped on traffic.
So, right. Can we agree that it would be good to decriminalize marijuana? So,
no, it would be good if police stop you too.
So it should be illegal for everyone?
No, we should stop doing it.
No, I'm trying to find an agreement place to agree with you.
Listen, we will never agree with each other. My knowledge is way above yours. I'm sorry.
Is that so? Okay. So your knowledge is way above mine. Okay. What was your SAT score? You know, if you want to talk about knowledge, what was your SAT score?